I suppose this is my only option, really. Here goes. Hocus pocus, alakazam. Magic, magic, get me out of this jam. What do you know? It worked. Sooty, eat your heart out. I've left the skull but taken the eye patch.
Where do you think you're going, eh?
Nowhere?
Mate!
Yes, Captain.
Okay, you pair of lily-livered, goose-pimpled landlubbers, pay attention. I have, after careful deliberation, decided that I'm not going to sell you as slaves after all. In order to satisfy my desire for sadism, I'm going to be forced to have you both killed. Therefore, at midday precisely, both of you shall swing to the yardarm, and I...
Captain?
Not now, not now. I'm dealing with the prisoners. And I shall watch with great pleasure as you...
Captain?
Will you stop interrupting, please?
It's quite important, Captain.
I'm sure it can wait 30 seconds. Now, where was I? Oh, yes. I shall watch with great pleasure as your necks break and you suffer excruciating.
I really think you ought to know, Captain.
All right. But it had better be important.
We haven't got a yardarm, Captain.
No yardarm, you say?
No, Captain.
Why not?
We've never had one, Captain.
Right. In that case, at midday precisely, you shall suffer the horrors of the torture chamber. We're hot.
Captain?
We haven't got a torture chamber either, have we?
No, Captain. Sorry, Captain.
No yardarm. No torture chamber. Do we actually have anything dangerous on this ship?
Not really, Captain. Health regulations, Captain. We've got quite a sharp spoon, Captain.
Wait a minute. I've had another idea. Right, you lot. There's been a change of plan. At midday, precisely, the pair of you shall walk the plank into the shark infant. We do have a plank, don't we? That's not too much to ask, is it?
No, Captain. It's just that...
Don't tell me it's against regulations, is it?
No, Captain. It's broken, Captain. We're just having it mended now.
Right. Fine. So, at midday...
More like about 3 o'clock, Captain.
At 3:05 precisely, you shall all walk the plank into the shark-infested one.
Not so much infested, Captain.
Don't tell me there are no sharks.
Wrong climate, Captain. Too cold for them. You see, your average shark...
Is there any even slightly dangerous marine wildlife around here?
I think there's a dolphin with a nasty disposition, Captain.
Dolphins aren't dangerous, are they? I thought they led sailors to safety.
Not this one, Captain. Leads them straight to the sharks. Got a bit of a thing going.
Good. Right, just to recap. At 3:05, you shall all walk the plank into the dolphin-infested waters and be led to your deaths. That okay with you, is it?
Yes, Captain.
No problem with that, is there? We're not breaking any regulations or anything.
No, Captain.
Good. In the meantime, however, you can make yourself useful. I like the cut of your jib, lad. My old cabin boy met with an unfortunate accident a few days ago. You can replace him. Who knows, if you're any good, I might spare your life. Mate?
Yes, Captain.
Bring him up to my cabin.
Yes, Captain.
Right. Do you know what a cabin boy is supposed to do?
No.
No captain.
No captain.
Nor do I, really. I suppose you'd better talk to some of the crew. They probably know. Okay?
Yes, captain.
Feel free to roam around until you find out what to do.
Yes, captain.
Right.
What a stroke of luck. Now all I have to do is find a mucus aid and get back to port. June 24th. Finally got underway with new ship. I think we'll head for the capital first to flog the loot. 26th of June. Really picking up on this pirating business. Cabin boy Jim Hawkins fell overboard and drowned. Crew giving me a hard time. 29th of June. My birthday today. Received 5 new pairs of long johns from crew. They think they're really amusing. 1st of August. Totally fed up with wisecracks about underwear. Next one of them to try it on gets it. 3rd of August. Executed 3 crew members to set an example. The others won't dare try it on again. 5th of August. The crew grow ever more subtle. I don't know which one to blame. I'm going to take it out on the 2 slaves we picked up in the capital. There's a postcard here. It's a postcard from Calimari. Dear LJ, having lovely time, weather good, food excellent. Met a lovely couple from down south. Wish you were here. Love, Captain H. P.S. This card's a lovely shot of the bay, isn't it? I thought you might want this eye patch.
Thanks. You can have these shades in return.
I'd better pick up the nails as well. Hey, tough guy.
Shut up, fool!
You don't happen to have a welding torch on you by any chance?
So what if I have, fool?
Can I borrow it?
I ain't got a light, otherwise I would have cut myself.
I think I know where I can find a light.
Okay, fool, but I'd better get it back, or you is history.
I don't think he'd appreciate my conversation. There's no point in doing that yet.
What do you think you're doing?
Just checking the door, Captain.
Keep away from this door, boy. Or else...
No problem.
Go.
Pentium Parrot.
A what?
It's a new model. It's got all the latest upgrades. Local beak, genuine lintel feathers, cracker co-processor. It's the appliance of science.
But we only just got the old one.
You've got to move with the times, though, eh?
I suppose so. But why's it fallen off its perch?
Just got to set up its beak BIOS.
Okay, then.
Meanwhile.
I wonder where Simon is, Grandfather. He's been gone for hours.
Don't worry, my dear. I'm sure he's perfectly safe.
We come for the wizard, okay?
Yeah, and you better hand him over, right?
Or there will be trouble.
With a capital P.
You got that?
He's not here.
Look, Mac, we know the wizard is here, right? Just hand him over, and don't try any funny things, okay?
Resistance is not a good idea.
That's right.
Not for you, anyway.
I'm telling you, he's not here.
Well, we is gonna search the place, see?
We find him, then we might just let you and the goyle go.
Noted, he said might.
Otherwise, what?
Just pray it don't happen.
Let's do it.
Later that day.
Looks like another ship. I wonder if they're friendly.
Thank you.
my inventory.